When one light bulb burns out in your home, do all other light bulbs also burn out? Of course, the answer is no, because they are connected in parallel circuit. So what do you mean by parallel circuit? Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is me once again, Teacher Tim, your science teacher for today's vlog. So for this lesson, we are going to discuss about the parallel connection and how to solve problem using Ohm's law with parallel circuit. But before that, if you're new to this lesson, if you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe, like, and hit the notification bell for more updates in Science 8. For today's lesson, we're going to discuss about the parallel circuit. Ano nga ba ang parallel circuit? Naitanong nyo na ba sa inyong mga sarili kung paano ba nakakonect ang mga circuit sa inyong bahay? Naitanong nyo na ba kung ano bang klaseng circuit or anong klaseng connection ang ginagamit nyo sa bahay? Is it series or parallel connection? So ano ba ang pinagkaiba ng series sa parallel connection? Okay, so when we say parallel connection, parallel circuit is an electric circuit in which two or more components are connected across two common points in the circuits so as to provide separate conducting paths for the current. So when one bulb goes out, all the other bulbs will still be working. Okay, anong itsura ng diagram if it is a parallel circuit? Okay, this one. Yan, so ganun ang itsura ng parallel circuit. So it's like they are having multiple wires. So, and usually kapag parallel circuit, hindi ang ang advantage nga niyan is pag nasira yung isa, hindi kagaya sa series circuit na masisira lahat ng bulb. There are three important rules in the law of resistance in parallel circuit. Ano po yun? So, di ba sa Ohm's law, wherein pag tumaas yung voltage, voltage is directly proportional with the current. If the voltage increases, the current will also increase. And it will decrease naman the resistance. So, sa parallel circuit, meron tayong tatlong kailangan tandaan in considering the... We have to remember the three rules to consider sa parallel circuit when it comes to resistance, current, and voltage. Ano-ano nga ba yun? Okay, simulan natin. So, pag sa resistance, which is para sa resistance, we will use 1 over RT is equivalent to 1 over R plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 3 plus 1 over 4. Okay, so to get the total resistance of parallel circuit, so kukuhanin natin ang sum ng reciprocal ng bawat resistances. So total resistance, reciprocal niyan, reciprocal ng total resistance is equivalent to the sum of the reciprocal of each resistances. Okay, paano naman kapag sa voltage? Okay, pagdating sa voltage, so tatandaan natin na ang ating formula para sa parallel circuit is the total voltage is also equivalent to voltage 1. Tina ang voltage, total voltage ay equivalent lang din 'yan sa voltage ng 1, ng 2, ng 3, ng 4. Ibig sabihin, kahit i-total mo pa 'yan, ang total noon ay equivalent lang din sa bawat voltage ng bawat bulb. Okay, how about sa current naman? Okay, when it comes to current, the total current is equivalent to, okay, so current 1 plus current 2 plus current 3 plus current 4. Okay, so that is the total current of each, okay, of each para sa ating current ng ating parallel circuit. So, ibig sabihin, i-add mo lang yung current ng 1, ng 2, ng 3, ng 4 para makuha natin yung total current. So, ganun po. Ito po yung 3 rules or 3 important rules to consider in making the parallel circuit, in computing or solving for the parallel circuit. Okay, so now, let's move on with the problem solving. Okay, so let us solve problem number 1 about parallel circuit. So, a set of bulbs consists of 5 350 ohms bulbs connected in parallel to a voltage of 220 volts source. What is the equivalent resistance of the circuit potential difference across each light bulb and current flowing through each bulb. Okay, so first, so we are going to use the Gresa method to answer this problem. So, let us start with the given. So, ano ba yung mga given na nakikita natin sa problem? So, we have 350 ohms. So, ano yung 350? Ito ba ay, since tayo ay parallel circuit, so, let's say for example, this is our diagram. So, meron tayong 5 bulbs. So, let's say for example, ito yung isang bulb, ito yung second bulb, ito yung third bulb, fourth bulb, and this is the fifth bulb. So, yung mang 350, yun ba ay resistance of the total resistance or resistance of each bulb? Of course, it means that is the resistance of each bulb. So, we have 350 ohms. 220 volts. So, what is that? So, that's the bulbs connected in parallel, a voltage of 220. So, we have volts of 220 volts. Okay, so ano naman ngayon ang ating required? So, for the required, okay, what is the, so meron tayong tatlo, 1, 2, 3. What is the equivalent resistance of the circuit? So, hahanapin natin ang total resistance. Potential difference, so we are referring to the voltage across each, so ibig sabihin, voltage ng bawat isa. And then, find the current. So, current, so that is letter I, flowing each. So, ibig sabihin, current din nung isang, nung bawat isang bulb. Okay, so now, let us have the equation. So, sa equation, idediretso na natin sa solution, ha? Para hindi takaw sa space. Okay, so for the A, so we are looking for the total resistance. So, paano nga ba isolve ang total resistance kapag parallel circuit? So, di ba kapag total resistance, that's the reciprocal. So, pag sinabing reciprocals, kabaliktaran. So, ang ating equation for total resistance, so we have 1 over total resistance equals, ilan ba yung bulb natin? 5. So, it means we have R1 plus R2 plus 1 over R3 plus 1 over R4 plus 1 over R5. So, kasi meron tayong, so ibig sabihin na hanapin natin ang resistance 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, kasi meron tayong 5 bulbs. Okay, so now, isubstitute na natin, ano ba yung ating resistance ng bawat isa? So, 350 ohms. So, 1 over 350 ohms plus 1 over 350 ohms. Okay? So, ngayon, paano ba nagso-solve na, paano ba tayo nag-a-add ng similar fraction? So, naka-fraction yan eh. And since pare-parehas yung kanilang denominator, so, adding similar fraction, so, we just have to copy the denominator, which is 350. So, 350 ohms. And then, i-add lang natin yung nasa taas. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, meron tayong 5. Okay, so 1 over RT. And then, ano ba yung reciprocal? Pag sinabi natin reciprocal, babalik ta rin lang natin. So, ibig sabihin, this is RT over 1 is equals to 350 ohms over 5. So, the answer will be, our total resistance is 350 divided by 5. That is 70 ohms. Okay, so it means our total resistance, the resistance of 5 bulbs is equivalent to 70 ohms. Okay. Ano ba kunin ang voltage ng parallel circuit? Diba sa parallel circuit, ang total voltage ay equivalent sa individual voltage. So, ibig sabihin, kahit gano'n pa kadami yan, pare-parehas lang yung kanilang voltage. So, ibig sabihin, kung mayroon tayong total voltage na 220 volts, so, ibig sabihin, yung 200 volts na total volts ay also equivalent to 220 volts. Ibig sabihin, lahat ng bulb ay merong silang 220... Ay, bakit ito'y 200? Okay, mayroon tayong 220... If the total volt is 220 volts... So, it means, ang volt ng 1 is is also 220 volts, also equivalent to 220 volts, and so on. So, since pare-parehas lang sila. Now, tayo naman sa individual current. So, ang ating current ay, paano nga ba natin kinukuha ang current? Diba ang ating formula is V equals IR. So, pag ilalagay natin yan sa triangle, so V equals IR, so it means I, to get the I, we have to use the equation V over R. So, ano ba yung voltage natin? That's 220 volts. Ang tinatanong dito ay current flowing through each. So, ano ang gagamitin natin ngayong resistance? Is it the 350 or yung 70 ohms? And since each bulb, individual resistance, so we will use the 350. So, 350 ohms is equivalent to, okay, so our total current is, that is equivalent to 0.629 ampere. So kung i-aano na natin i-round off, so that is I is equivalent to 0.63 ampere. Okay, so this is the result of our problem solving. So our resistance, the total resistance is 70 ohms. Our volts is, since this is 220 volts, equivalent to 220 rin yung bawat isa. So, limang bulbs ay meron dito 220 volts. Pare-parehas lang sila. And then, yung ating current, so 220, which is the volts, na 220 divided by resistance of each bulb, which is 350, that's 0.629. So, pag i-round off natin, it will become 0.63 ampere. Okay? So, remember that resistance ang ating unit for resistance is ohms, our volt is volts, voltage is volt, and we have sa ating I or current, we have VA or ampere. This is the end of our lesson vlog about the parallel circuit. So in our next video, we are going to discuss how to compute a problem using series connection. So, sana may natutunan kayo sa video na to. And you can take notes para naman kung may isosolve kayo problem para sa inyong mga video lesson. Okay, para sa mga estudyante ko sa STE Tulip, Jasmine and Marigold, I hope na nakatulong ito para masagutin nyo ang yung performance task number 11. So that's all. So if you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe, like, and hit the notification bell for more updates in Science A. Bye!